Right, next one, order of reaction. What is the order? So order of reaction means sum of the power of the concentration of terms. What is that? Sum of the powers of the concentration of terms. That is we call the rate of reaction. Order of reaction we can be defined as sum of the power of the concentration terms is called the order of reaction. What is that? Sum of the power of the concentration of terms. Look at here, I'm taking the A, this is the reactant to formation of product. Now is the A, I'm writing the rate of reaction for this one, dx by dt, directly proportional to A, right? Dx by dt, that is equal to K into A power of 1. Here concentration of the reactant is the 1. So that's why order equal to 1. Now simple, I give the second one example. A plus B gives rise to product dx by dt. This is the rate of reaction directly proportional to A into B. A concentration 1, B concentration 1, power of 1. A power of 1, B power of 1. So dx by dt equals to K into A power of 1, B power of 1. So order of reaction, which order? Second order, 1 plus 1, sum of now adding. The concentration of reactant, 1, the concentration of reactant, second one. The concentration of A reactant, concentration is the 1, reactant B is the 1. So sum means adding there, 1 plus 1, that is the second order. Here only one reactant is there now, so that's why it is the first order reaction. So I give the simple example, next one, look at here. So M is the concentration of A, N is the concentration of B, the formation of product. Now how we can write rate of reaction? Dx by dt directly proportional to A power of M into B power of N. Yes, A power of M, B power of N. So what is the order of reaction? Order of reaction is the M plus N. Sum now, adding there, the concentrations are adding. M plus N, this is the order of reaction. What is the meaning of order of reaction? Sum of the powers of the reactant terms. So reactant terms, I take the reactants of the concentration adding there. That is we call the order of reaction. Right, I go to the zero order reaction. What is a zero order reaction? The rate of reaction does not depend on the reactant concentration. What is that? The rate of reaction does not depend on concentration of reactant. So means the rate of reaction does not depend on the concentration of the reactant. That is called the zero order reaction. Zero order reaction. What is a zero order reaction? The rate of reaction does not depends on the concentration of the reactant. Look at here. This is the A. A is converted to product. Product. Okay, clear. At time t, what is that? At time t, time t equal to 0. Now product is not forming. Time 0 now, there is not forming a product. That's why product is a 0. A of the concentration small a. A of the concentration small a at a t equal to 0. Time equal to t. So after some time, so for example 1 hour or 2 hour, 3 hour or 20 minutes, time equal to t. Now the product is x. Product is x after t time. Now reactant of the concentration here a minus x. A minus x. A is the reactant. A reactant is connected to the product. Time t equal to 0. 0 time, on the 0 time, A reactant of the concentration A. After t time, concentration of A, A minus X. Look at here. I'm applying to the rate of reaction dx by dt directly proportional to A. This is the reactant. Now reactant's concentration here in the 0. Yes or no? That is a zero order reaction. Rate of reaction does not depend on the concentration of the reactant. Concentration is the 0. So how we can write that one? Look at here. Dx by dt, that is equal to K naught, means constant 0, zero order constant, into A power of 0. Here, therefore, A power of 0 means concentration here is a 0. That's why I'm write the dx by dt, that is equal to K naught into 0. Clear? So finally we only write here concentration 0 now, that's why K naught 0. So we can write the dx dt is going to the out of the equal to, so that's why dx, then after K naught into t. Here is a concentration 0, that's why is a remain K naught only. Clear? Now dx equal to K naught into t. Now here integration both side. Integration both side. Look at here. Integration on both side. Look at here. Now integration dx equal to K naught integration dt. Okay, after integration, here remain value x, that is equal to here K naught into t plus c. C is the integration constant. This is the integration constant. So this is the formula 1, equation number 1. Let's see here. At initial stage, x equal to 0. Initial term, here is the C, product is not forming there. X equal to 0. Time equal to 0. At time t equal to 0, x equal to 0. Time t equal to 0, x equal to 0. Product is not forming there. So when you apply this x equal to 0 on the equation number 1, 0, that is equal to K naught into 0 plus C. So 0 k naught into 0 0, 0 equal to 0 plus c, finally 0 equal to c. So this is a equation number 2. Clear? This is equation number 2. Right here, equation number 2 in the equation number 1. From equation number 1, from equation number 1 and 2. What is their one? X. Okay. X equal to remain k naught into t plus 0. 0 c equal to 0 now. C equal to 0. So in that place of c equal to 0. Right now remain values x equal to k naught into t. T come to the out of the equal to. How we can write x by t that is equal to k naught. So that is here we write k naught equal to x by t. So this is a zero order derivation. Zero order derivation. The constant the zero order constant equal to the directly proportional to the concentration of reactant and with respect to the time. So this is zero order reaction. So first look at here, A is converted to the product. Now at time t equal to A of the concentration A, small a, at time t equal to t, time t, now in that time concentration of A minus x, product is formed, that is x minus a, sorry, a minus x. Now finally when you apply the here is a derivation. So when you apply into the rate of reaction dx by dt directly proportional to a naught. Now here is a when you in that directly proportional to, you have to take that constant value dx by dt equal to k naught a naught. A naught means here is the concentration 0 now. That's why I'm taking only k naught. Now dt come to the out of the equal to. Now k into t. dx equal to k naught into t. So at here what is there here? Now here integration on both side. Here integration on both side. Integration dx equal to k naught dx dt. X equal to k naught into t plus c. C is the integration constant. Okay, clear? At initial time or at initial stage, t equal to 0, x equal to 0. So 0, here is a 0, k naught, okay, t equal to 0 plus c. Okay, totally 0, k naught into 0, 0 plus c. C equal to 0. So equation number 2, this is the equation number 1. So from the equation number 1 and 2, x equal to k naught into t plus 0. So x equal to k naught into t. So t is come to the out of the equal to, that is x upon t equal to k naught. K naught equal to x upon t, that is a zero order reaction. What is the zero order reaction? The rate of reaction in that reaction in which the rate of reaction which cannot be depend on the concentration of the reactant or reactants, that is a zero order reaction. This is the derivation. Okay, clear? What is the order of reaction? Order of reaction means sum of the power of the concentration terms, that is called the order of reaction. How we can define that? Sum of the power of the concentration of the reactant, that is order of reaction. Order of reaction means we have to adding there the number of concentration values of the reactants, sum there means adding there. The every reactant they having this the different of concentration values, that power values are to adding, and that power value, when you are adding that power values, we get the order of reaction. That is maybe the first order, that may be the second order, maybe the third order, maybe the zero order. So order of reaction, it always be either zero or even number, sorry, either zero or maybe in whole number or maybe in the fraction. So the order of reaction we can be determined in experimentally method, but not in the theoretical method. That we can be find out in by the experimental method. So that is the order of reaction. First one, sum of the power of the concentration of terms. That is a definition. Now it is in zero or whole number or in fractions. Third number we can be find out in experimental method. So that is the 4 points. And next one, I go to the zero order. Zero order means the rate of reaction which cannot be depend on the concentration of the reactant. That is we call the zero order reaction. Means the rate of reaction R equal to, it's not depend on the concentration. R is not depend on the concentration. Clear? That is a zero order. That's why I'm taking it as the product of the concentration here. Look at here, zero. That's why we're getting the constant value zero. That is no. So this is a dx by dt. Dx by dt is, what is that? That is equal to R. R equal to what is that? Dx by dt, that is a represent the rate of reaction. So constant is a zero. Means the reactant of the concentration zero. That's why it is the zero order reaction. So finally, the rate of reaction does not depend on the concentration of the term. Is that clear? Term, what is there here? Reactant. That is a zero order reaction. Okay, clear? Right. Write down.